Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is bout number 13, which is an under 63.5 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing in the red corner, wearing white and gold with red vest, and hailing from White Hart Lane, give it up for Super Cam, Cameron McKay! And across the ring, his opponent boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the green and gold of Repton Boxing Club, give it up for Giorgio Vizioli! Your referee, Mr. Paul Rosendale.
Welcome back to the Virtue Motors Arena for the second half of our NAC 2023 finals. First up we have Cameron McKay versus Giorgio Vizioli in the under 63.5 kilogram championship final. Super Cam, Cameron McKay in the red and Vizioli, Giorgio Vizioli in the green with the blue gloves. And here we go, immediately underway.
Giorgio Vizioli beating Amali Davis last week on his birthday weekend to secure his place in the final today.
Big flows from the pair of them here. Very technical fight we've seen so far though. Lots of feints from Super Cam. Nice shot as he left the inside there from McKay. Vizioli ducking and rolling, escaping danger very, very well.
McKay just whipping some shots into the body there, trying to get himself out of that tangle. Referee steps in. Again, fast-paced bout from the off, and this is looking to be another great bout. Absolutely. In the NAC finals.
That's a beautiful roll out of danger there on McKay's part as well. Been boxing for 4 years up to this point, compared to Vizioli's 6 years. Giorgio started when he was 8 years old in kickboxing and later switched to boxing because of more avenues to make a career and money. Biggest achievements include winning the NACs at 60 kilograms and winning the Tri-Nations in 2022 as well. He's also a national and international champion in the sport of kickboxing before moving over to the sweet science. And you can see it on display here, being elusive to escape the threats of McKay.
McKay is studying sports business management at the University of Hertfordshire and made it onto the GB squad last year.
He's idol as his coach, Chris Hall. He's won 3 national titles himself, so he's under very good tutelage underneath that learning tree there in his corner. Yeah, the even contest here as the final 10 seconds come underway. I don't like to be the judge of this one. Very close. Oh, but they wobbled him. Or was that a slip? I'm not sure what that was.
Well, styles certainly make fights, don't they?
Absolutely. I think from the referee's lack of stepping in or anything there, that must be registered as a slip rather than a clean hit. Very interesting first round there between Cameron McKay and Giorgio Vizioli. Under 63.5 kilogram NAC final here.
It'll be an interesting one. They both have similar relaxed counter-punching styles. Vizioli just on the back foot there. It'll be an interesting one, and again, probably quite tough to score.
Yeah, it really is a game of inches, this one. Very, very close, hard-fought contest so far. Both men raring to go though. Paul Rosendale getting us going once again in this second round. Second of three if we need them. 3 minutes on the clock. Here we go again. Fiery start, just like we did in the opening round.
Both boxers trying to assert themselves in the second round, find their own rhythm. It's just getting a bit messy there on the inside. But Vizioli just landing a couple of really clean shots just there.
Cameron on the hunt though is Cameron McKay. He is looking for something. He's looking for that moment to turn the fight on its head.
Mike just needs to pick his lead hand up a touch there to avoid him getting caught on the way in.
Yeah, quite a loose and low guard from both fighters here, from both boxers. Beautiful attack into the body there from McKay. Shielded by Vizioli though, but still.
Vizioli just switching direction quickly to keep his opponent switched on, guessing what way he's going to go. He just makes those minor adjustments with his feet and comes in with his straight shots to set the other hand up.
Yep.
He's working that really well at the moment.
And a very nice left hand just caught him then. Caught Giorgio Vizioli on his way to our right, but he answered back. And the two are definitely giving as good as they're getting anyway. Halfway through the second round now, nearly a minute left of the contest of this second stanza.
McKay's corner just urging him to let his hands go. Certainly needs to land a few more scoring punches in this round.
Warning to McKay for lowering his opponent there. Okay, trying to offer a response back here, but just coming up short. Very active though.
Is he only just finding his jab and moving off at his angles? It's working well for him. Mm-hmm. It'd be nice to see them work on the inside a little bit.
Yeah, he's being hunted, he's being chased down by McKay, but McKay isn't able to land anything at the minute, nothing substantial.
It's with very limited success.
Yeah, very, very limited success. He's not driving home any big shots or anything. He might be keeping him on the back foot, but he's not scoring himself. So that does make it a difficult one to call.
Absolutely. Vizioli's definitely getting off with the cleaner, more convincing work there. Good second round.
Yeah, the Repton representative in the green and yellow with the blue gloves intended to by his corner. The ultimate round coming up now. Yet to have a finish on these cards tonight. Had a couple of close calls, but nothing in the form of a stoppage so far. Every bout going to decision. That's how closely contested these bouts are. I'd hate to be a judge on a day like this. And here we go, the third and final round, the final 3 minutes. 180 seconds to settle the fight.
McKay's just out of range with those shots. Vizioli's just able to stay with him. Although he's getting through there.
Yeah, he broke through
really
with a few
punches. Really working into the
body there. Yeah.
Definitely needs to start getting his feet in a little bit more, McKay, to land those shots. He's very busy.
Yeah, he's showcasing some really funky footwork, but he's not doing anything substantial with it. He's getting a lot of advice from his corner to try and be more active, try and make his shots count. But Fizzioli just remaining very elusive and hard to hit at the minute.
Fizzioli's got good punch economy here. He's really sort of picking his shots well. Most of what he throws lands. So after a busy start to the bout, he's really settled and he's really made this bout his own.
Yeah, he's found his form in this bout. Has Fizzioli maybe on course to a decision victory. Halfway through the round now, 1 minute 30 gone, 1 minute 30 to go.
These rounds go by so quickly.
Yeah, it's hard to really stamp your authority if you are behind and try and get back into the fight in these 3 3-minute rounds. Dean Palmer, your hands 1 second and far away from you the next. As McKay's finding out here.
Yeah. He's got the right idea, McKay, just keeping that head moving, trying to get in from behind his jab, but Vizioli's just keeping him out of range and getting off with his own punches.
Nice inside body work, trying to score, essentially, is McKay. But to no avail, really. Oh, and he eats a nice right hand there.
He's just picking him off with his straight shots. His boxing, he's got the right tactics here, Vizioli. He's just picking him off. Nice work on the inside there.
Yeah, his pivots and his footwork and his angles and everything.
And there's the clappers for the last 10 seconds.
A well, hard fought third and final round there over the course of three-minute rounds. In this under 63.5 kilogram bout for the NAC Championship. We'll have to see which way this went, but Prey, I'd love to get your final thoughts on that bout.
I think Vizioli picked his opponent off really well there. I think he was more effective with his straight shots. I think he used his angles incredibly well, and McKay just wasn't able to land the shots that he needed to land.
And with that, we throw it to our MC, Craig Dunham, for the official decision.
So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards where your officials and ringside. Scoring unanimous decision victory. All in favour of your new male under 63.5 kilo national amateur champion, boxing out of the blue corner, it's Giorgio Vizioli.
Giorgio Vizioli. He picks up the victory here and his biggest accolade yet in the NAC Championship at 63.5 kilograms. Incredible performance over the course of the three rounds. You know, statement made. Now he joins the illustrious list.
I think, you know, he really made a statement today. He got the, you know, it was the right decision to make. He won that well. He's saying that his ambition is to turn pro and win titles. Well, I think he's just taken a big step towards that goal. Congratulations to him.
Absolutely. And with that, we move on to Dionne Bowman and Sophie Colborne in the under 66 kilogram female category. And we'll be back with you just in a few minutes. First female referee of the evening to officiate this all-female bout as Dion Berman and Sophie Colborne collide in under 66 kilogram action for the Women's National Amateur Championship. Straight out the gate immediately there was Sophie Colborne, no messing about, putting Berman back into her own corner and really putting the pressure on immediately, Priya.
Berman boxes well on the back foot though. She's your boxer mover. So Sophie Colborne needs to be careful not to walk into those straight shots and check hooks of Dion Berman.
Yeah, Sophie coming out of Liverpool but now lives in Portsmouth. Working in the Royal Navy and has boxed for 15 years. A very experienced scrapper in the ring, as well as Dion Berman with her 9 years and a full-time GB Academy boxer as well. Going to boxing while playing football and was doing quite well at football, but instantly fell in love with boxing at a boxing class with one of her friends and decided it was a sport for her.
Sophie Coleman says that one of her motivations is that she backs herself, and you can see why. She's made a strong start to this first round.
Yeah, not a backstep taken from her straight away in this fight.
Just trying to rough up Dion Berman there on the inside.
A high pressure situation here for these two absolute warriors in the ring.
Sophie Coleman won the Junior and Youth ABA Championships. She was the Royal Navy Sportswoman of the Year. She's won the Haringey Box Cup. She's won a Winter Box Cup. She's a very decorated boxer indeed at the age of 26. Dion Berman, a GB Academy boxer. Again, very experienced.
Yeah, a plethora of experience inside the ropes here. Some nice activity on the back foot by Dion. Dion Bowman then. You can see her throwing some shots that connected with Sophie Colborne. But Colborne just swarming her when she gets her in the corner. Absolutely all over her then. Final 10 seconds of this first frame.
Colborne's tactics are right here. She's going forward. She's trying to push Dion Berman back onto the ropes. Berman just showing signs of frustration at the end of that first round.
Yeah, very frustrating round for her, and I don't know what kind of fight you come out expecting, whether some people are slow starters, some people start fast, and I think that's the case with both of these women here. Like, you saw Bowman come out and like thought she could kind of get a range a little bit, but Colburn didn't give her any chance and decided to sprint straight to the other side of the ring and put it on her.
Absolutely, she's showing no respect here, Colburn. She's going straight into Berman, trying to get past her long range shots, and with considerable success.
100%, and we'll have to see now how she reacts to a very frustrating first round for her. Maybe she can kind of stop that momentum that she's that Colburn is building. As his second round gets underway, Harry Williams and Priya Ganesha calling the action here at the Virtu Motors Arena in Newcastle upon Tyne.
Berman just managing to find her range a little bit better at the beginning of that round, but Sophie Colbert again showing no respect. She's going straight in there.
Yeah, she has a ruthless approach to this contest. Not willing to take any back step whatsoever. It turns into a bit of a dogfight.
She can't afford to either. If she allows Berman to settle into her long range back foot boxing, she's going to find it really hard.
Standing count for Dion Bowman,
who looks surprised to receive it.
Yeah, she didn't look to be in too much trouble, but if the ref feels like there was a need for it, then...
You see everything as the ref in that ring. We can't always see what they see.
Yeah, exactly.
And Hillary Lissenden is an incredibly experienced referee. Work it out, work it out. Very
well, very well. On out, on out. Some nice body work there, but Dion Bowman retorts with a couple of shots to the head.
She's really not letting her work, Sophie Coleman.
Yeah, she's remaining on the inside as often as she can, trying to shut down Berman's game plan and Berman's reach here. And she's doing the tactics working very, very well. Berman turned away for a second there. Another standing count. A quick barrage then. Put upon Bowman, and Bowman again. Bowman a bit bemused.
She seems bemused. Hopefully that won't affect her focus for the rest of this round and going into the third round. It can really sort of take the wind out of your sails if you're receiving two counts in a round.
Yeah, not only that, but it'll help the judges as well.
Certainly makes it easier to decide.
Exactly.
It's not the deciding factor, but it doesn't help.
Still trying to fight her best fight, that was Bowman here.
Sophie Coleman really looking to rough her up.
Yeah.
See what happens in the last 10 seconds of this round as Bowman comes back.
She's really trying to turn this into a dogfight here. And the two
definitely
are scrapping.
That back.
Oh, just a little one, just a little bit after the bell there.
She's definitely getting frustrated, Bowman. She really needs to compose herself and clear her mind. She needs to focus on this last round.
It's a very, very dangerous game plan to approach a contest of this magnitude with a foggy head after a frustrating two rounds.
See her coach trying to talk her down as well.
She needs a big, big
and really asserting herself in those first two rounds. If she can keep it up for the third, I have a feeling she will win the decision.
Third and final round underway here. 66 under 66 kilogram championship. Sophie Coleman in the blue and Dion Bowman in the red. And the fight immediately begins just how it left off. Better responses here from Bowman. Some very nice shots landed there on the chops of Sophie Coleman.
Definitely looking for and finding a home for that southpaw rear hand, Bowman.
Yeah, she landed a couple of nice shots there, including a nice shot to the body in that overhand right.
She needs to prevent Sophie Coleman from roughing her up on the inside and spoiling her style, but Colburn's definitely having some success there. She has done in the previous two rounds.
Very nice little duck and roll there from Bowman. She continues to pour it on here.
She needs to do that straight after she's thrown her shots and landed, though. She's standing in front of Sophie Coleman just that bit too long for Coleman to come back and land her shots and attack.
Yeah, a minute and a half to go here. Everything's on the line. All the victories that got her, got the two women to this final. Who wants it more here? Berman really trying to pick up a couple of shots here. Very nice combinations in her own corner there.
She needs to be looking to pin Sophie Colburn to the centre of the ring rather than allowing her to push her back into these corners and ropes though.
Final minute of the contest underway. And Colburn is just trying to put it all over Berman now.
She's really smothering her work here, Sophie Colburn, much to the frustration of Berman.
Yeah, she's trying to turn the pressure around now and put it onto her woman.
Works well on the inside, Sophie Colburn, with those bent arm shots. She tucks up. She's not afraid to let her hands go, is she?
Not at all. And here we have it, the final seconds of the final round. And the two are still trying to swing hell for leather here.
Absolutely slugged it out right until the final bell.
Very fun contest over the course of those three rounds, but I think it's a pretty safe bet now that Sophie Colburn will be leaving with a championship around her waist, Priya.
I'd agree with that for sure. I think she really sort of smothered Dionne Berman's style. Berman likes to box on the back foot. She likes to keep it long. I think she could have made better use of her angles a lot quicker after her attacks. Sophie Colburn was able to take advantage of that, and I think she did so effectively.
We'll throw it to our MC, Craig Dunham, for the decision.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, man number 14, please show your appreciation for both boxers. So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. We officials at ringside score a split decision 4-0 in favour of your new national amateur champion at under 66 kilos. Boxing out of the blue corner, it's Sophie Colburn. A round of applause, both boxers.
An elated Sophie Colburn there, and a very disappointed Dionne Berman in the opposing corner. Massive congratulations to Sophie Colburn on capturing a huge accolade in the NAC Championship. Final thoughts on the performance, Priya?
We've just witnessed a beautiful moment between Sophie Colburn and her coach. It just means so much to them. She's absolutely delighted, and she deserved that win.
And with that, we'll be back in just a couple of minutes with our next contest between Huey Malone and Ram Singh in the under 67 kilograms.
Gentlemen, this is band number 15, which is an under 67 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the white shorts, red vest, and hailing from Christ the King, give it up for Huey Malone. And across the ring, his opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the white, black, and gold, and hailing from Limehouse Boxing Academy, give it up for Ram Singh. Your referee. referee in charge and the bell, Mr. Jeff Canal.
And here we go, bout number 15 of this year's National Amateur Championships. This one under 67 kilograms between Huey Malone. Oh, Huey Malone and Ram Singh, who come out immediately swinging. Huey Malone in the red, Ram Singh in the blue, and the two are just tagging each other here for fun, prayer.
Yep, they haven't waited around to feel each other out in the first round. They've absolutely gone at it. Huey Malone beating Waqas Ali last week in last week's semi-finals to secure his place in the final this week. Ram Singh beating Anton Essen.
Yeah, similar in age. Huey being 20 years old and Ram Singh at 19. Two big lads for the weight bracket. And still they are, oh, and Huey Malone landing clean several times there.
Looks like he's going for the stoppage here.
100%, wasting absolutely no time. Calming his aggression just a little bit is Malone.
Ram Singh trying to box on the back foot with his straight shots, but not quite landing them with the conviction that he needs, although that backhand got off quite quickly. Quite well, sorry, should I say.
The referee resumes. And this nitty-gritty contest continues.
Ram Singh, an electrical engineer. Huey Malone, a bricklayer. Both want to make their families proud.
Yeah, Ram Singh might be the electrical engineer, but it's Huey Malone who wants to turn his lights out and spark him. With the way he's come out flying in this contest.
I'm not sure I could have put it better myself, Harry. Malone just being encouraged by his coaches to stick to his boxing, not to get too involved.
Straight back to it, a barrage of shots from both competitors here. 15 seconds left of this first round.
The point deduction for Ram Singh.
Yeah, that point deduction is going to be massive if this does end up going to decision. If this does go all three rounds, it will definitely be a big factor.
Those things can make the biggest difference between a win and a loss, a title and not a title. I'm sure his corner's going to have something to say about that. We've got Ricardo Shah in his corner there. Just needs to recompose him.
Very important period of time this here in a championship contest. Look for a few moments in that contest where Huey looked to have stunned Ram Singh and he could have followed up on it, but fair play and a credit to the chin and the durability of Ram Singh to get back into the contest.
He's done well to get back in. It'll be good to see both boxers settle a little bit in this second round.
And I don't think we're going to get any settling
no
at all as they come straight back out gunning for one another.
Absolutely no chance. Ram Singh being reprimanded by the referee again.
Both of them picking up where they left off with every exchange. Nice nice body shot from Ramsey, trying to get back into the contest here.
He lands too many more of those. It's definitely going to slow Malone down. Ramsing's just caught Malone with a decent couple of right hands there, right on the button.
Yeah, Malone's taking a couple of shots here in order to give a few back, but it's the smartest thing to do is to put yourself in harm's way.
Absolutely, he might have a chin on him, but it's not smart.
They're countering well now. Ooh, just missed with an overhand left there, did Christ the King Church representative Malone.
Ramsing just shoving his opponent around the ring again, being warned. Can't afford to keep taking warnings like this. He really needs to tidy up his game here.
Yeah, Singh trying to find his way back into the contest here.
He's just smothering Malone's work. Malone really needs to sort of work long to mid-range to avoid that.
Oh, that's it.
That's it, he's been disqualified.
Numerous occasions here, he has warned him, he has tried to give him the benefit of the doubt as often as he can, but Ram Singh cost himself the not only the victory but the championship after a hard fought fight and a hard fought journey to the gold. He gets himself disqualified, he's his own worst victim here.
It's a really, really disappointing way to have to leave a championship and lose in the finals, but ultimately we're operating at elite level here and the expectation is that much higher.
Yeah, you're only really amateur by name in your conduct. You really need to be more professional than that.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, battle number 15, please show your appreciation for the boxers. So ladies and gentlemen, your winner by disqualification and the new male under 67 kilo national amateur champion boxing out of the red corner, it's Yui Malone. A round of applause for both boxers.
And there we have it, our first stoppage ish along the way tonight.
I'm sure on some level Huey Malone's disappointed with the way that he won that, but at the end of the day, a win is a win, a title is a title, and he goes home the victorious man today.
And now we move on to our next contest between Kayla Allen and Chantel Reed, females under 70 kilograms, and we'll be back with that in just a couple of minutes.
And firstly, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the all red with white trim, and hailing from Hoddesdon, give it up for killer Kayla Allen. And across the ring, her opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing all black with white trim, and hailing from Code Red Boxing Academy, give it up for Chantel Reed. Your referee in charge, Mr. Cameron Kong.
Cameron Khan getting us set for this contest here between Kayla Allen and Chantel Reed for the under 70 kilograms NAC Championship. Kayla Allen in the red representing Hoddesdon and Chantel Reed in the blue representing Code Red. Kayla Allen comes out and takes the center of the ring straight away, popping a few jabs. And Reed answers back with a few of her own.
Kayla Allen says that she turned to boxing after her football scholarship funding fell through because of COVID. Changed direction and finds herself in the final of the National Amateur Championships.
Incredible to say she's only been boxing for 3 months. Kayla Allen, that is.
Absolutely, absolutely. It just goes to show how much you can achieve and how far you can go when you work hard for it and move forward towards your goals. She's doing incredibly well at the moment.
Yeah, especially with the biggest achievement, saying going to Sweden, having only been training for 4 weeks and winning Golden Girl over there. Very impressive stat, and shows that she might have been in the wrong sport all along. Maybe she'd made for boxing.
Maybe this is where she's supposed to be. She's clearly fearless in her pursuits. She's going in with Chantelle Reed, who is a two-time European and world bronze medalist at youth. She won those medals as a youth. She's obviously going in with somebody who is an accomplished boxer already.
Yeah, she definitely looks like she belongs at only 3 months in. Taking a couple of shots there down the pipe, though, from Chantelle Reed. Reed with a plethora of shots there, right down the barrel. Snapping the head back of Kayla Allen.
I think Chantelle Reed's experience is definitely going to show here. But Kayla Allen is coming forward. She's showing no respect. She's coming in. She's there to win.
Yeah, absolutely no messing about. I mean, she tried to come in and dictate the and control the fight immediately, popping her jabs from the centre of the ring. But Chantelle Reed is just firing back now and looking like she's growing with every single strike she's throwing. A scrappy affair here.
Already down to the last 10 seconds of the first round, with both boxers having asserted themselves really well into this contest.
Yeah, Kayla Allen definitely giving a good account of herself in such a short space of time since entering the sport. Took a couple too many shots in my opinion there from Chantelle Reed, but we'll have to see how her corner redirector for the second round, that's coming up in just 1 minute. Definitely think you had a point there, Freya, before when you said that you think Chantelle's experience is going to play a big part in this bout. I feel like it was starting to come to fruition in the first round a bit, but the inexperience of Kayla that was allowing her to just try and put the pressure on Reed and not be as composed was also kind of posing a threat to Chantelle Reed in the same manner.
Something naively fearless about Kayla Allen here.
Yes, I think that's a much better way of putting it, as we come out for the second round. Big heavy shots from Kayla straight away. No backing down from a much more experienced opponent. Although she does keep getting clocked down that centre line. Head keeps snapping back.
Chantelle Reed using her jab really well.
Combinations on offer from Reed. Especially as a two-time European and world bronze medalist at youth boxing, as mentioned before. Plethora of experience that she's bringing into the ring tonight.
Scrappy in parts, but both girls straight back on it as soon as the ref says box. No waiting.
Yeah, and Alan just not backing down at all. Like, really good head movement on her as well as she's storming forward. It's remarkable to think how new this woman is to boxing.
She is gonna, it looks like she is going to keep coming for the entire bout. This is what she's done from the first bout, and I think she will continue to do so until the last. She's not going to make this easy for Chantel Reed, although Reed is landing with some decent jabs here, just trying to keep her opponent at bay, just getting in on the inside with some body shots. They're the ones that are going to slow her down, if anything.
Mm-hmm. And that's why they call Alan Killer K. Dangerous with her hands and never stops coming forward, evidently, as we're seeing in front of us here in the Virtue Motors Arena in Newcastle. Big shots again from both women, but still, even as they're both throwing, it's Alan whose head keeps getting snapped back. Another big right hand from Reed.
Alan, at the moment, is only 18 years of age, just turned senior. Win or lose, she has a bright future ahead of her.
Yeah, 18 in fall, 3 months into boxing against a 24-year-old who's a former two-time European champion. It's a big, big step up, but that's what you expect in the NEC finals. No such thing as an easy fight.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. These girls are really setting the standard here.
Very nice work again as we enter the final 10 seconds of the second round. And a great shot down the pipe from Chantel Reed there. But answered back with a flurry of shots from Kayla Allen, who just will not quit whatsoever.
She's got the heart of a lioness, I think. And I'd say that about both girls, actually.
Yeah, very, very good fight. We have a boxing match that we have on our hands here. Great work. The pressure that Kayla Allen is putting on Chantel Reed is only making this contest that much more delectable. We're enjoying breaking down this fight at ringside here. Both still look relatively fresh as well as we go into the third and decisive round.
Chantel Reed, who says her idol is Chantel Cameron, and she is influenced by her father. She loves to travel, and the best place in the world, according to her, is the Caribbean.
Here we go, round three of three. Breaking the action here. Yeah, one of Kayla Allen's idols is Alicia Bowmanger, a super featherweight standout who's quickly risen up the ranks just as she's trying to do here herself. Not a bad idol to have.
Absolutely not.
And we get straight back to it.
Kayla Allen started to train in her garden by herself, looking at videos on YouTube, and then went to a club to learn some basics, ended up staying, and here she is.
It's absolutely amazing.
What a wonderful story she has.
To see how far she's come in such a short space of time. She's definitely only going to get better, and this is a credit to her abilities and her drive to get this far in the national amateur championships with such little experience. It's incredible.
Chantel Reed says her goal is to be the smartest female boxer in the world. I don't think she's far off at the moment.
Yeah, she definitely boxes a smart fight.
Absolutely, she picks her shots really well. Uses a variety of shots. And takes advantage of every opening that she can find, just like she is here now.
Yeah, she has a very good jab, and that right hand still again just going straight down the pipe on Kayla Allen. She seems open for it no matter what she does. It just keeps seeping through, but she's landing some of her own very good shots as well. She's not backing down at all.
She's not backing down. She's getting in with those little flurries to the body as well.
Yeah, she's
Kayla Allen.
She's willing to eat a couple of shots in order to give some to a much more experienced opponent. She's giving a very, very good account of herself.
Her nickname's Killer K. I can see why. I think they need to add the word fearless into that somewhere. Yeah.
Seconds left of this round and of this fight, of this boxing match. Final 10 seconds underway here.
And again, neither girl backing down. It's been a relentless end to that match.
I mean, they make it look very easy to do that for three rounds. But for three minutes, that is not an easy pace to keep. Especially some of the shots that both of them are eating.
Absolutely. Especially those body shots. They really slow you down and take the wind out of you.
Yeah, very, very good account from both ladies there. But as always, we give it to our MC, Craig Dunham, for the official decision. Chantel Reed picks up another momentous win, another accolade, another one for the win column. Tremendous performance over the course of three rounds against a very durable, a very hard-fought competitor. Prayer, your final thoughts?
I think she absolutely deserved to win that decision, but Kayla Allen should absolutely leave this contest with her head held high. She has a bright future in the sport, I've no doubt about it.
And with that, we'll be back in just a couple of minutes when we get back to the men's action as Callum Makin takes on Mason Payne in under 71 kilogram action in just a couple of minutes. Hold on tight.
Gentlemen, this is band number 17, which is an under 71 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner in the black and gold, and hailing from Rotunda, ABC, give it up for Callum Makin. And across the ring, his opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the blue shorts, white vest, and hailing from Ropes and Glory, give it up for Mason Payne. Your referee in charge, Mr. Tony Buff.
Our 17th contest of the evening underway here. Callum Makin in the red, Mason Payne in the blue. Mason Payne with a very fitting surname for the contest that's about to go ahead, and these two come out straight away, no feeling out process, and straight to it, Prayer.
Absolutely, they're really looking to assert themselves into the contest.
Yeah, and you're starting, oh,
themselves to be the dominant boxer of the two. Hard to tell which one's which at the moment.
You're starting to see a differential, a change now as we've progressed through the weights. Started off at near 48 kilograms at the start of the show. Now it's 71 kilograms. We are seeing a massive difference in the weight behind the shots. and the style of fights that we're getting. The style of bouts that we're getting are a lot heavier, a lot harder, much harder hitting is. And the crowd here is reacting to every single strike that Callum Makin throws out. The Rotunda man putting it on him.
Callum Makin started off doing kickboxing, trained with his father, he says. He's been boxing for 13 years now.
Yeah, we've had a few people tonight who've transitioned over from the kickboxing arts for the lack of the progression in the scheme that's there. Hoping to still make it in a contact sport like boxing.
You're doing incredibly well.
Yeah, it's not too bad if you get into the NAC finals anyway.
Absolutely, a beautiful rear hand there, just landed by Mason Payne.
And 13 years boxing for Makin. Winning his first national title as a schoolboy. Setting him up very well to win an NAC here tonight, if possible.
Nothing in it with the ages of these two, with Callum Makin 19, Mason Payne 18 years old, but Callum Mackin's coming into the ring with 13 years experience compared to the 6 years of Mason Payne.
Yeah, Mason Payne with the more of the typical boxer's approach. Boxers on the side, really, is a roofer in his day job. So he's an absolute grafter and he's taking some of these shots as well. Very well here.
Mason Payne won the junior developments and he wants to make his family proud. I'm sure they are very proud that he's made it to the finals here today.
Absolutely. And as a roofer, if he is able to pick the win up tonight, he might just raise the roof. You see how he can stand and bang in front of Mason Payne here. Callum Makin and Mason Payne going at it.
Both boxers with a significant amount of support in the arena today. They've really brought their supporters and their families with them today.
It's the first round in the books. Very fun opening frame there between these two 71 kilogram combatants.
Difficult one to really call. They both came out wanting to assert themselves, wanting to establish themselves as the dominant boxer. You know, I think it would be good to see them both settle a little bit into the second round and third round moving forward. But definitely landing with some clean shots between the two of them.
Yeah, very calm and composed corner work here from the teams. Nobody rushing in and nothing too hot and heavy this early into the fight. We're only one round down, still two to go.
Yeah, no one's panicking at the moment, which is good to see.
Here we go, second round about to get underway here. A much calmer approach, but I don't feel like it's going to stay that way for long.
I don't think so. Both looking to pick their shots.
I think this might be the amateur level, but it is still a game of fine inches.
Nice jab there, just landed.
Elite level boxing on show here. Great hands from the duo.
Both boxers trying to get their lead hand over the top of the others to land that lead jab. We've obviously got a southpaw and orthodox boxer here.
Yeah, Makin wasn't feeling too uncomfortable stuck in the corner then either. Happy to let his man come to him. Very nice body shot there from Makin. The Rotunda man ripping at the body of Mason Payne.
He's really showing good ring awareness here, Makin, as he boxes on the back foot. Again, not unusual for a southpaw boxer.
Here again, it's the old battle of orthodox versus southpaw and the entire puzzle that that poses in itself.
I think Mason Payne is actually is handling this quite well. He's landing with his rear hand, sort of moving towards the outside of Mackin's lead, which is really where you want to be. But just being warned there by the ref for use of his shoulder.
Yeah, great ring awareness from Mackin, as you said. Not feeling too stressed at all when he is in the corner. Oh, a nice crack down the centre line with that looping left hook from Mackin.
The referee's definitely taking a close look here.
Yeah, the tenacity and attention in the Virtue Motors Arena has definitely picked up with this contest.
He's really landing well with his rear hand, Mackin. Mason Payne can't afford to keep taking those shots.
Very nice uppercut there from Mackin.
Yeah, just snaps his head back. Mm-hmm. Those are the shots that catch the judge's eye.
And as the round closes, I think that may just be a round that Mackin has snatched.
I think so. He's definitely landed the cleaner shots. He looks more composed. He's picking his shots well. Remains to be seen.
Still very calm corner work, which is sometimes where fights can be won and lost. A lot to play for in this third round, though. It may be one apiece. Wait and see.
Mason Payne listening intently to what his coach is telling him in the corner.
This is a big occasion for both fighters, both boxers.
But they've risen to the occasion really, really well as we go into the third and final round.
Yeah, Mason won the junior developments on his way, as well as seeing his brothers win accolades as well, and he'll definitely want to continue joining their ranks. Wiping down the back of Mackin's neck.
Looks like he might have sustained a cut on the back of his head there. Doctor's just taking a look.
We've got to be careful of the position of the fighters, what they're swinging and what they're catching. Bit of a brawl breaking out here in Newcastle.
Both boxers really looking to clinch that win, to take the belt home this evening.
So much on the line here, and these lads are scrapping and fighting for the chance to hold that gold. But it's a game, as I said earlier, of fine margins. And the victor will get the spoils.
Mason Payne just looking for the counter punch as Mackin comes forward, but just not quite getting the timing of that shot right.
Very nice work.
Although hit with a nice rear hand to the body there.
Elusive movement from Mason Payne. Trying to time that counter. As the Rotunda man comes in. Both men having issues now, landing clean and flush on one another. Both kind of figured out each other's timing. That brings it to a little bit of a stalemate, but then, as you just saw, Mackin lands the cleaner shots and is immediately met with another one straight back at him.
Looks like the cut on the back of Mackin's head is starting to open up again.
Yeah, starting to drip down the back of his hairline, as we can see.
Those kind of injuries are a bit more prevalent since the headguards have been removed from the elite males. Although we haven't, I don't want to speak too soon, but we haven't seen many cuts today.
No. Been a relatively clean day so far, but we still have the big boys to come. The unit alarm will be sounded, and we'll have to see what comes later in the evening. Into the final moments of this third and final round. Crowd are hot and heavy here in Newcastle for this one.
And the two swinging in, looking to finish strong as the 10 second clapper goes. And what a great finish to the third and final round.
Fantastic finish to the fight. I think Mackin just happened to land the final strike clean, a big left hand. But a very, very close bout. Priya, final thoughts on that one?
It's definitely a close contest. They both boxed well. They both came out absolutely trying to assert themselves into the bout. They did so. For me, I think Mackin's experience just showed a little bit there.
And we'll throw it to our MC, Craig Dunham, for the official decision.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, band number 17, please show your appreciation for both boxers. So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards where your officials at ringside score a split decision 4-1 in favour of your new male under 71 kilo national amateur champion and boxing out of the red corner, it's Callum.
Massive congratulations there to Callum Mackin, taking home the NEC 71 kilogram championship. A valiant effort from his well-matched opponent Mason Payne. Over the course of three rounds, it just seemed that Mackin's shots were just a little bit cleaner as we look at the highlights here, Priya.
Yeah, I mean, if we're looking here, Mackin's shots were just cleaner. He just managed to find his range and his timing just that little bit better than Mason Payne. But again, a very well fought contest, and I think a split decision was definitely fair.
And with that, we'll be back in just a couple of moments for under 75 kilogram action between Jerry Lee Palmer and Mary Kate Smith in the females division.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is bout number 18, which is a female under 75 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the all black with white trim, representing the British Army on behalf of the UK Armed Forces, give it up for Jerry Lee Palmer! And across the ring, her opponent boxing out of the blue corner, wearing all black. And hailing from Telford, ABC, give it up for MK47, Mary Kate Smith. Your referee at the bell, Mr. Mike Hemming.
About 18, and it's the battle of the double barrel first names as Jerry Lee Palmer and Mary Kate Smith go to action in under 75 kilogram female NEC championship action here. Three minute rounds if we need them. And Mary Kate comes out straight away. She walked down that end of the walkway on a mission. Coming out guns blazing. And how apropos that her nickname is MK47. She comes out swinging. Big time. Some of these shots that we can hear at ringside here, absolutely bouncing off the dome. Jerry Lee Palmer. Oh, a beautiful right hook.
Yeah, both girls have literally come out to assert themselves into this contest. Both come out gunning. Mary Kate Smith, just 19 years of age, has been boxing for 3 years, compared to Jerry Lee Palmer, who is 28 and has been boxing for 10. She's also a Spanish tutor and a boxing coach outside of her competitive boxing career.
MK47 holding a accolade in the national developments. Showing a barrage of strikes already in this first round. We're only just halfway through the opening stanza.
Jerry Lee Palmer just showing her repertoire of punches here. She's really going in with everything. She was the finalist in the 2021 and 2022 national finals. She's hoping to get the win this year.
Third time lucky, hey?
She was also the Spanish champion in 2019. She's using her bent arm shots really well on the inside there, Jerry Lee Palmer. Both girls going toe-to-toe. I think it's going to boil down to who can sustain this pressure for the longest.
Absolutely. Mary-Kate Smith just trying to walk her down repetitively here, repeatedly putting the pressure on, and some of her shots, like clinical boxing, just every bit of technique, sharp, concise, technical boxing that she's unleashing onto Jerry Lee Palmer. Jerry Lee firing back though.
She is relentlessly coming forward. Is Mary Kate Smith. She's really trying to keep the pressure on Jerry Lee Palmer, forcing her to go backwards. With Jerry Lee Palmer's corner trying to tell her to keep it long.
Oh, and MK47 just got her head wobbled at the end of that round then. She had two body shots and just let herself exposed. Opened up a chance for Jerry Lee Palmer to fire a left hook in. Okay, knocked her head back for a second. But a very fun opening first round there.
It was very eventful, you know, both girls going in, they were pretty much toe-to-toe for the entire round. Again, difficult to score, especially with the bent arm shots there, with both of them sort of going at it. I think Jerry Lee Palmer would be a little bit more successful if she just got in from behind her jab and pushed her opponent back from behind her jab.
Incredible to see how far the NACs and the former ABAs have come now. Here in front of a capacity crowd at the Virtue Motors Arena. Here we go, the second round underway. Hard to tell who was leading that first round, so still everything to play for in the second. Ooh, big shots again.
Jerry Lee Palmer really using her combinations well. Just needs to get herself off the ropes there. Get back onto her jab.
Just the relentless pressure put on by MK47. Just walking her down repeatedly is Mary Kate Smith, constantly just on the front foot at all times. Doesn't necessarily mean she's winning, but she's looking like she's controlling the contest.
Jerry Lee Palmer able to manage that pressure though. She's starting to try and use her jab a little bit more now. You know, good head movement there. She does run the risk of looking like she's being overpowered when she's on the ropes. Yeah. But she doesn't look like she's in any real danger. She got off with a decent jab just there. This is exactly what I was saying in the first round. She can get behind her jab and the straight shots. she'll be able to neutralise the pressure of Mary Catesby.
Very nice combos at the same time. Almost identical shots to one another.
They've both got similar styles, actually, which is always good to see, because it always makes it really competitive. But MK47 keeps firing.
Unlimited rounds coming from MK47. And Jerry Lee answering back, though, remaining well in the contest. Very nice combinations. Just knocked the head back of the Telford ABC representative there.
It's those shots that catch the eyes of the judges, those straight shots just like that that rock the head back. They're your convincing punches, they're your scoring shots. She just needs a few more of those. Just keep MK47 at bay.
Yeah, those are the ones that kind of rattle your composure a little bit. We've seen him in full flow here. And sometimes the head guard can come into play a little bit and kind of obstruct the vision.
To be able to sustain this work rate over three rounds, though, is unbelievable. It's really tough, and these two girls are really showing that they've got a serious engine.
We'll have to see if anyone can impose their will in the final frame here now. All to play for. As far as the judges, how do you see this one?
I feel like it's quite even at the moment,
yeah.
To be honest with you. I feel like it's quite even. I feel like going into the final round, it will be the boxer who is able to sustain that pressure for longer, more sustained. Like I said, I think Jerry Lee Palmer really needs to get behind her straight shots to avoid giving Mary-Kate Smith the opportunity to get off with those bent arm shots if she wants to make it a convincing win in the final round.
All to play for still in this very, very razor close matchup.
It's amazing to see both girls still looking quite composed after the two rounds that they've had. Starts off with a great stiff jab from Jerry Lee Palmer. That's exactly what we're looking for.
Oh, a standing count coming to the person who's been dominating this bout so far. Very, very nice way to start the contest for Jerry Lee Palmer. Doing the British Army proud here in this performance.
Coach is just calling for her to stick to those straight shots.
Yeah, they've worked menacingly throughout this entire fight, entire boxing match.
Just going in a bit low there with her head, MK47, but keeps firing. Again, calls from her corner to keep her punches nice and straight for Jerry Lee Palmer. She was definitely more successful there. But just allowing MK47 to push her back into the ropes.
Big work rate coming now in this final minute and a half. We're halfway through. Who wants it more now? You know, the judges have got to be thinking about that standing count.
Absolutely.
Just non-stop action in each of his faces every step of the way.
Just being told again by the ref.
Yeah, we've already seen one disqualification tonight. We don't need more. Got to keep your act together and don't lose your cool.
Again, just getting behind those straight shots there for a moment, Jerry Lee Palmer. But MK47 is relentlessly coming forward in this match. The work rate is just starting to dip a bit for Mary-Kate Smith.
Yeah, we might not be getting all-out slugfest stoppages and knockouts tonight, but what we are getting a chance to see is a lot of the next generation and the fitness and the caliber that they have at this level on a serious platform on BBC Sport. Beautiful body shots coming back from Jerry Lee Palmer.
Really going for it in the last few seconds here.
And there we have it. Three more rounds in the book. A very close fight. And it all depends now how the judges saw the standing eight count for Mary-Kate Smith. Both look fairly confident of which way the decision's going to go. But we'll have to send it to our man in the ring, Craig Dunham, for the official decision.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, band number 18, please show your appreciation for both boxers. So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. We officials are ringside. Score a split decision, 4-1 in favour of your new female under 75 kilo national amateur champion. And boxing out of the red corner, it's Jerry Lee Palmer.
Jerry Lee Palmer takes home the gold and the big, big victory to become the under 75 kilogram champion here. A big, big performance there, Priya.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is band number 19, which is the under 75 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the green and gold of Repton Boxing Club, give it up for Jimmy Sainz. And across the ring, his opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the black and gold. And hailing from Rotunda ABC, give it up for Steve O'Clark. Your referee in charge, Mr. Billy McDonald.
Billy McDonald in charge of our contest, our 19th contest of the evening. There's Jimmy Sainz in the red and Stephen Clark in the blue. Lock horns in under 75 kilogram final action. Big, big reception here for the Rotunda man, Stephen Clark, and it's another Repton versus Rotunda clash. All the marbles on the line in this hotly contested matchup.
Yeah, it's a very evenly matched final here. Nothing in it as far as their age is concerned. 22 years of age, Jimmy Sainz. 21 years of age, Stephen Clark. both have boxed for England.
Yeah, Jimmy with somewhat of an advantage in his experience for 16 years to Stephen's 9. But nevertheless, both find themselves on a very similar platform. That's very at the same stage of their careers. Everything to play for, as we've said. Fantastic back and forth here.
Starting to get into the bigger weights now.
Absolutely.
Some of the bigger punches, and you can really hear it at ringside. Jimmy Sane's just getting off with his jab really well at the moment. Answered by one from Stephen Clark.
The most amazing thing about all the contests throughout all the weights today is the activity level hasn't dropped a notch. It's been fantastic fights from start to finish.
The work rate has been phenomenal.
Yeah, and the atmosphere in here is on par with that. More big shots coming from Steve-O. Steve-O in the black and gold. And the Repton man, Jimmy Sane's in the green and gold. Both looking to add to their respective gold tonight. Taking home the under 75 kilograms championship. It'll be a massive staple of their careers if either man is able to do so. And they are both boxing like it. The life is on the line. Great shots from both lads.
Both sticking to their boxing, which is good to see. Using a combination of punches. Really using the jab well, which is always great.
Both jabbing the hell out of one of each other's faces. They'll be looking like a ransom note by the end of the night if they carry on this in this style. Watch for the heads again. Especially with no head guards in the elite
slipped
level.
Those two shots really well there, Jimmy Sane's.
Final seconds of the first round, and he's landing big here. Big ovations around the building for Steve-O Wood, Steve-O Clark.
Again, a decent opening round from both boxers.
Yeah, true game of fine inches, fine margins between the two. Very evenly matched, very even levelled bout we've got on our hands here. Both going tit for tat in the ring.
They're both just trying to take control of the contest. I think it's going to boil down to who can do it first.
Yeah, they both know what's at stake here. You know, Jimmy's already won the youth NACs and boxed for England against Germany. And his goal is to be the best. That's his one goal. And we'll see if he can double his money, double his accolades. With a senior elite NAC along with it. Sharp jab as well straight away. But Steve-O answers back. Great movement from the duo here. Fast high octane action. Right in front of our very eyes at ringside.
I think Stephen Clark just moved his head out of the way.
Yeah.
He's able to slip those shots quite effectively and get in with his own. As you said, the second boxer from the famous Rotunda Boxing Club, home of Natasha Jonas when she was boxing as an amateur. Jimmy Sane's from the equally famous London Repton Boxing Club.
A great matchup in front of our very eyes here. And the atmosphere in here is adding to it with every single shot that lands. Cheeky, nice little shots inside from the Repton representative. But Steve-O comes firing back straight away. And Saints lands a couple of uppercuts. Watch for the sneaky headbutts there.
We'll need to be careful with those heads before you know it, you end up cut, and the contest might come to an end, mm-hmm. depending on where that cut is.
Repton and Rotunda head to head once again. These two lads boxing at a very high level for a very young age.
You can really tell they're coming into the ring with a lot of experience. Able to stay composed under pressure.
And still neither man's breathing that hard. It's into the final minute, the second round.
They are making this look easy. Just being told by the ref to stop holding.
Very nice cheeky shots on the inside there from Sainsley. Steve will answer him back, and they both got the same idea with left looping hooks.
And we're just coming to the end of the second round. These rounds are flying by now.
And that's it. One more round to go in this fascinating under 75 kilograms matchup. All to play for in this third round. They've both gone tit for tat. Hard to say which way the judges are leaning in this one, especially from our standpoint. Then again,
absolutely,
we're not judges.
I'm glad I'm not judging this one. It wouldn't surprise me if it went to a split decision if the final round goes the same way that the first two did. Be interesting to see if Sainz is 16 years of experience compared to Stephen Clark's 9 starts to show in the final round.
A lifetime of boxing already under his belt, and he could have another belt to put on top of that belt if the third round goes in his favour. Electric atmosphere in the Virtu Motors Arena here in Newcastle. Harry Williams and Priya Dinesha calling the action here. Very nice shots. Just catching Sainsley on the top of his head there was Steve-O. The crowd erupting with every single shot that's thrown. Popular lads in the arena right now. Nice inside looping uppercut from the Repton product. Sainsley again doubling up on his shots. Steve-O again answering back.
Yeah,
just missing.
He's starting to relax a little bit, I think. Jimmy Sainz finding his way and really catching Clark with some eye-catching shots, but really, really settling into the bout. He's really relaxed now.
Yeah, great head movement, great level changes from Sainzy. I think he may just be edging this one the way it's panning out here.
Nice little hook to the body there from Sainzy.
Again, everything he's giving back as well. Oh, and a nice shot from Steve-O. Just kind of drops the guard momentarily off Sainsley then. Another right looping uppercut from Sainsley.
And we're almost down to the final minute of the final round of what has been a really closely boxed contest.
Both of them just going toe to toe, head to head, trading blows. so much on the line here. The legacy of the NEC is up for grabs. To join the illustrious list of those who've come before us, Steve Owen Sainsey, 30 seconds. Who wants it more? Beautiful shots from the duo. Incredible stuff we're seeing here.
They've absolutely both done themselves so proud with this performance. It's been a tough contest for both of them.
Again, we continue to say it's a shame one man has to come home empty-handed, because you want neither man to lose. But what an experience, what a fight, and what three rounds we've just experienced.
And again, the atmosphere here at the Virtue Motors Arena is absolutely electric on what has been a fantastically fought contest.
Yeah, both lads boxed smartly enough in what they could in a very difficult contest. Saint and Steve-O gearing themselves up for the official decision. So we'll hand it over to our man, MC Craig Durham.
So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards, where your officials at ringside score a split decision, 4-1 in favour of your winner, a new male under 75 kilo national amateur champion, boxing out of the blue corner, it's Steve-O Clark
takes home the under 75 kilogram championship. Fought very, very well to take it. Commiserations to Jimmy Sainsey, who fought a very, very hard fight himself. Incredible battle over three rounds. Priya, your thoughts?
I'm not surprised it was a split decision. I thought it was very close. In parts, I thought Jimmy Sainz was just edging the match, but we only see it from one angle. We don't know what the judges are seeing from the other angle, but congratulations to Steve-O Clark. Very well fought contest.
A brilliant contest, and that brings to a close our 75 kilogram matchup for the night. We move up to the bigger boys now. Under 80 kilogram action next, as Ola Dimeji Shitu takes on Lucas Roig, and that will happen when we come back in just a couple of minutes.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is bout number 20, which is an under 80 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, firstly boxing out of the red corner, we're in the black and gold, and hailing from Five Star, give it up for Ola Dimeji Shitu. And across the ring, his opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, we're in the all white with black, and hailing from Dale Youth, give it up for Lucas Roig. Your referee in charge of the bell, Mr. Mohammed Al Salawi.
And here we go, our first bout in the under 80 kilograms NAC action here. There's Ola Dimeji Shitu takes on Lucas Roig. Under 80 kilogram action, here we go. Shitu in the black with the red gloves, of course. And Lucas Roig in the white with the blue gloves.
It's an all-London affair in this final. Mm-hmm. Dale Youth versus Five Star. Lucas Roig coming in slightly younger and more experienced. Says that his idol is his previous fellow teammate who boxed with Dale Youth, George Groves. Comes in with 8 years experience compared to Ola Dimeji's 4 years experience at the age of 21. Both boxers making a calculated start to this first round.
Sasha Chu reached the finals of last year's NECs as well, and the Box for England Cup. He's also one of the in the emerging talent program. Idols of Muhammad Ali and Larry Holmes, big throwbacks. Nothing wrong with being an admirer of the old legend of the game. Been boxing for 4 years and currently works at McDonald's to fund his training. He's interested in boxing. Came from messing around with friends in his friend's garage, but then wanted to go from there and learn how to box properly, all the way to where he is today.
Certainly learned to box properly. He's doing well with that jab.
Yeah, big long arm, big long reach. It's quite a stunning reach that he has when you see the arm fully flexed out.
He really has, yeah.
It's a really long limb. Very, very smart. Somewhat of a refreshing change from our last couple of absolute scraps we've had.
Absolutely, absolutely. Maybe reflective of the fact that we're getting up into the weight divisions now, yeah, at under 80 kilos.
Yeah, you have to fight smart at these weights, because this is now the weights where the big shots can end things in an instant. While Sheety may be orthodox, he does have some unorthodox tendencies that keep his opponent guessing.
Yeah, he's got quite a deceptively awkward style as Sheety, just catching, growing with his jab on the inside there. Just starting to get a bit scrappy now.
Yeah, Rohrig also is a NEC finals, been here before, and also won the London Championships in basketball. He's a multi-sport athlete. As the first round comes to a close now, the razor close first in the first inning we have there, and we'll have to see how the bout begins to open up in the second round.
Yeah, I think both boxers started off a little bit cautious, started getting into it as the round progressed. It'll be good to see them come into their own in the second round.
Yeah, and here we go. Second, preparing to jump out as the second round looks to begin.
Shitu's corner saying just box.
Yep.
Exactly what we need from him.
It's much steadier pace here with these two. So far,
I think Lucas Rohrig really needs to get in from behind his jab and really establish that jab as he moves forward. He's just getting picked off here, finding it hard to get past the long limbs of Sheety.
Maybe Sheety's jabs are not bringing anything to write home about, really. But that was a nice right hook from him on the inside.
He's not using the advantage that he's got to, you know, really establish himself. He could really kind of keep Lucas Rohrig at bay well if he just stiffened his jab and really got his feet in.
Yeah, closely contested All London affair here.
Nice head movement there from Lucas Roerig. Just needs to come back with his counters though and really have an answer for everything that Shitu's throwing at him. Lucas Roerig is finding Shitu's switch of stance and awkward style quite difficult to get past and really sort of able to box his own bout here at the moment.
Yeah, it's a very difficult style to either imitate or overcome. Very, very fast on them legs as they Shitu. Final 10 seconds of the second round. Big shots there at the end of that second round.
Maybe just sense some slight frustration on the part of Lucas Roerig as he goes back to his corner.
Yeah, still looking like a very, very tough one to call, Priya.
Moving well, Shitu. He's using his angles and he's using his switch of stance really well. He just needs to be a bit more accurate with those shots. They're not landing with the conviction that he should really be landing with at this stage.
Third and final round underway. A scrappy affair straight away there. Continuing his unorthodox approach is Shitu, but he's having a bit more success with those jabs there.
Really dancing around the ring, using the space of the ring, making it hard for Lucas to really pin him down.
Yeah, he does have some magnificent footwork and ring awareness to avoid the onslaught that Roerig is trying to put on him.
It's a really difficult way to box, the way that Shitu's boxing at the moment. You need to be supremely fit to be able to dance around the ring for three rounds straight when you've got someone like Lucas Roerig in front of you who's really trying to land his shots and does so with some success here with that jab.
He's trying his best to keep Roerig at bay though with them long arms. Roerig has managed to get past a couple of times now, but it's still a very, very evenly matched contest here.
I think Shitu's just been a bit more successful in this round in picking Lucas Roerig off with his long, straight punches and angles. Should be working on the inside at the moment.
Big shots there, big backhands as well, back of the glove, smashing Roerig. There's a two tie up in the corner. Reset in the middle, once again, final 40 seconds of this 80 kilogram contest. Between Five Stars representative Shitu and Dale Youth's Roerig.
Stop. Kutu doesn't show any signs of his feet slowing down at all as we go into the last 10 seconds of the final round.
Not at all. Some brilliant cardio on him. Barely broken a sweat here in this contest. Good show of sportsmanship there at the end. After a couple of blows, just got through. Your thoughts on that one, Priya?
I think Shitu took it for me, to be honest with you. I think he picked Lucas Roering off well. Some of those shots earlier on in the contest could have landed with more conviction, but I think he found his range and he found his ability to establish his long straight shots as we went into the final round. I don't think Lucas Roering was quite able to settle into the bout.
Over to Craig Wall.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, bout number 20, please show your appreciation for both boxers. So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. We're your officials and ringside scoring split decision. 3-2 in favour of your new male under 80 kilo national amateur champion. And boxing out of the red corner, it's Djemi Shitu. A round of applause for both boxers.
Oladi Meji Shitu picks up a big piece of gold in his amateur career. Brilliant outing over the course of the three rounds. Priya, your thoughts? I think you were right once again on the decision.
I might have missed my vocation in life. Maybe should have been a judge. But no, I think Shitu did really well to win that. It was a great contest to see. Commiserations to Lucas Roering, but no doubt he will come back stronger next year. He's still young, only 19 years of age.
And with that, we continue to bump up the weight as Grace Buckle and Emily Asquith collide in 81 plus kilogram female action next. Don't go anywhere.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is bout number 21, which is a female over 81 kilo contest. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner, we're in the yellow and black, and hailing from Miguel's ABC, give it up for Grace Buckle! And across the ring, our opponent boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the red shorts, blue vest, and hailing from Bridlington, give it up for Emily Asquith. Your referee at the bell, Mr. Lee Innes, MBE.
Lee Innes getting us ready for our 21st contest of the day. Here is Grace Buckle from Miguel's, takes on Emily Asquith from Bridlington. Grace Buckle feeling very, very inspired and motivated following her teammate, Ghanaian boxer Seth Gima, aka Freezy McBones, who's a boxing idol and a good friend of Grace's, who won his professional debut last week against Daly Sharp at Frank Warren's Queensbury Promotions. And she's coming into this very, very motivated off the back of that, she said.
And she is up against Emily Asquith, who comes to us into this final as a 2-time European champion, 20 years of age. Grace Buckle, 31 years of age. She is a British Sign Language interpreter, says that she wants to use British Sign Language in the fitness industry to support people with a hearing impediment to take part in fitness. Her nickname is Amazing Grace for no reason.
Yeah, big age differential between Emily and Grace here. Asquith at 20 years old and Buckle at 31. Emily's boxed for 9 years though to Buckle 7. Grace actually found boxing after seeing a friend of hers working a charity fundraiser boxing bout and decided it was a perfect way to get involved and try and lose some weight, and before you knew it, the bug had bitten her and she was competing.
And here she is in the NAC finals.
It's always the way, isn't it? The people who come into the gym and say they have no intention of competing always end up competing and doing very well.
Yeah, they find the organic love for the sport.
And we're over halfway through this first round now. Still feeling each other out a little bit here, a little bit tentative in this early frame. Corner demanding double backhand, double right hand.
Asquith needs to just work inside when she gets there. Her feet are still just slightly out of range, although she got Grace Buckle with a couple of decent straight shots just there.
Yeah, Buckle doing well, controlling the centre of the ring here. But as a corner is saying, she needs to step on the pace a little bit of a slow and sluggish start to the fight, to the opening round of this 81 kilogram matchup. We're expecting some stern advice for both corners in between rounds here. You know, a bit of a slower start, so hopefully we can get more action in this second round. There's definitely like a void that needs to be filled here.
Absolutely. I think Grace needs to really sort of establish herself behind her straight shots. She is the slightly taller boxer, and she needs to make it hard for Asquith to get in behind her jab and really get her bent arm shots in at close range. I think both boxers are trying to establish themselves. They need to really dial it up in this second round.
Second round getting underway here. Grace in the black and gold and red gloves, while Emily Asquith in the blue with the England shorts on. Nice jab to the body here, picking up the pace just a little bit more composure in this round. More intimate setting now as we get through these later bouts on the card. You can hear everything from the corner teams. It creates a much more intimate space where both competitors can hear both each other's corner and try to counter what they're expecting to come.
I think Buckle's really sort of she's doing well to move to the outside of Asquith's lead. She needs to really kind of come over the top of Asquith's lead hand with her lead hand. But it's going to be hard for the judges to score this, really. Neither boxer really landing with any clean punches as we've seen previously.
Yeah, Grace just missing on a couple of these shots here, but she's remaining active and looking for an opening, as is Emily Asquith. Asquith trying to dictate the pace now. Trying to control the outing halfway through this round.
I think Asquith needs to look to slow Buckle down by going to the body a little bit more in this round. Done well with her rear hand there, Asquith. But she needs to be working on the inside here.
Buckle's corner demanding more pressure.
Asquith's experience at international level is going to carry her through this contest.
Yeah, two European Championships as well, representing England boxing.
She's trying to really go for it, Asquith, but getting tangled up in the long arms of Buckle.
Final 10 seconds of the second round. The punches aren't offering too much. Not much power behind them at this point. Wonder if fatigue is starting to kick in. But it hasn't been that high velocity of a contest, really, has it?
I think it's tough at that weight as well, though.
Yeah.
When you look at, you know, what you're carrying around at 81 plus kilos, it's a difficult weight to be at and sustain the kind of fast pace of the 50, 60 odd kilo boxers. But I think they're doing well to kind of stay in the bout. They're staying with each other. For me, I think Asquith just edged that round.
Yeah, I think she's a bit more active in that one. And we'll see now, going into the third round, how close of an outing this is. So much on the line. Big moments of corner work here, big advice. As they come out one last time, 81 kilograms. Here we go.
Asquith looking the slightly more tired of the two boxers, could have potentially punched herself out in the previous round, but she's still going.
Yeah, them legs looked a little bit heavy then when she went to come in. A little bit of fatigue starting to shine through.
Yeah, Buckle really needs to start landing her straight shots. She gained some success with a rear hand a few seconds ago. She needs a lot more of those if she's going to win this.
Yeah, 2 minutes away from glory. The pair of them. It's who really wants it more here? Telling Asquith to keep her head up here with 2 minutes left of the bout.
Buckle's not quite sure how to handle the velocity of punches of Asquith. Seems to be getting a bit overwhelmed by them. They're not quite able to get her counter punches off.
Yeah, Buckle just trying to pick the pace up a little bit here. Great corner work as well, instructing very loud and precise into the ring. Very nice right hand from Buckle there, and combination there. Six punch combination from Buckle.
Asquith is just trying to stay in the pocket there and not allow Buckle to work, but she's managing to get those shots off.
Great work from Buckle there as she tries to make Emily Asquith buckle in the same way. Big work. Nice combinations coming through now with 35 seconds to go from Buckle.
She's really finding herself in this bout now with those combinations. She might have needed to have done that a lot earlier on in the bout though.
Absolutely. When you've only got three-minute rounds, you can't really afford to waste any time. 10 seconds to go. 10 seconds for glory.
Amazing right hand from Grace Buckle there.
10 seconds for glory in history, and here we go. Asquith and Buckle go the distance once again. Our 21st contest of the evening. Full day of boxing has been on show here with some of the very best of the next generation, and some already arriving. And now we'll give it to our man Craig Denham for the official decision.
So ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards where your officials are ringside. Scoring split decision, 3-2 in favour of your new female 81 plus kilo national amateur champion. Boxing out of the red corner, it's Grace Buckle. A round of applause, both boxers.
Grace Buckle does enough in the eyes of the judges over the course of three-minute rounds to take home the 81 kilogram women's championship. Fair play in a very, very fun contest there. Both ladies put it all on the line. Your final thought, Priya?
They both worked incredibly hard. They both wanted it. But she is amazing, Grace.
And with that, we're on to our 22nd of 24 bouts this evening. Up next, we have Isaac Oko against Adam Aloare. And we'll be right back in just a few minutes.
Gentlemen, this is bout number 22, which is the under 86 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner, we're in the all black and hailing from Dagenham Boxing, give it up for Isaac Oko. And across the ring is opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, we're in the green and yellow and hailing from Empire School of Boxing, give it up for Adam Ola. Your referee in charge, Mr. Stu Mann.
Second bout of the evening underway now, and we go up to the bigger boys, the under 86 kilograms, between Isaac Oko and Adam Aloare. Isaac Oko in the red and Aloare in the blue.
Isaac Oko, son of Christopher Oko from Chadwell St Mary Boxing Club in London, also amateur coach for Nina Hughes, who is current world champion. This bout is incredibly evenly matched. It's probably one of the most evenly matched bouts we've had today. Isaac Oko, 20 years of age with 5 years experience. Adam Aloare, 21 years of age with 6 years experience. Adam Aloare was last year's NAC finalist, looking to correct that loss this year.
Yeah, and he feels very, very confident pre-fight that he is going to win it this year. When we asked him about his accomplishments, he'd already said that this is his accomplishment, winning this. He's from Lagos, Nigeria, but now lives in Newcastle as well. So another adopted hometown boy on the card tonight. Coming up against the Dagenham Boxing Club representative in Isaac Oko.
Isaac Oko, also the seventh GB boxer to have competed in the finals today.
And a low just landed a nice left-right combination on the face of Oko. Oko stunned a little bit.
Comes back with his own rear hand though, Oko. This is looking to be an exciting contest at the under 86 kilogram weight division. Isaac Oko says that his motivation is to win world titles, get loads of money and drive fast cars. Why not?
At least he's made his intentions clear.
There's no ambiguity about those. But he's just starting to pick off Allure at the moment with that long lead southpaw jab.
Some big shots there pouring out of Adam Allure.
Adam Allure is here to get the win. He is not going to make it easy for Oko.
Yeah, they are both swinging and swinging hard here.
Chin's a little bit high on Isaac Oko at the moment. Could be dangerous. Adam Allure's got a big few punches there that he's looking to land.
Yeah, very, very high tempo set in this first round. If we can get two more rounds of that, we may see a stoppage. Your thoughts on that first round, Priya? How do you think that went?
I think Oko established himself slightly better in that first round, although Adam Allure went in with some big shots. I think Isaac Oko knows what he's up against in Allure. Allure is looking to land those big shots and really, really make an impact here.
The veteran analysis, as always, here in the Virtue Motors Arena. Our 22nd bout of the day. Only two more to go. And the weight keeps increasing up. Our next two will come in 92 kilogram action. But first up, it's Oko and Allure in the second round with the 86 kilogram NEC Championship up for grabs. Both still trying to establish that jab. With Allure chucking a little bit more output at the minute. Oh, a beautiful shot to the sternum there. He's Allure having a lot more success with that.
He's definitely
and it's turning into a bit of a slugfest now. Beautiful counter right hand from Adam Allure.
I think both boxers walked into a decent shot from each other just there. Isaac Oko, smile on his face, really enjoying his moment.
The pair of them again going tit for tat.
Encouragement from Isaac Oko's corner to be first and third. Needs to be careful with that head, Oko.
Yeah, when the tempo starts to get really high, accidents can happen.
Both boxers trying to rough each other up on the inside there.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration showing through a little bit. Listen to the referee though here, trying to get this contest out of hand, but they are swinging.
Again, Allure's getting some success with his bent arm shots, but Isaac Oko is just managing to pick him off.
Oh, big shots landed on the jaw then of Allure from Oko, finding a home.
Oh, got that kind of Tyson Fury relaxed style, hasn't he, Oko? Mm-hmm. Such a big lad.
Yeah, looking very loose and very, very confident now that his shots are starting to find a home. It's a bout that keeps flipping each way. A lovely body shot immediately as the action resumes from Oko.
We could absolutely hear that at ringside, Harry.
Yeah, big shots. Great timing from Adam Allure to duck under that swinging, looping left hand of Isaac Oko. And the second round comes to a close, Priya.
Really was an exciting round. Adam Allure says that he doesn't want to be less than what he's capable of being. I don't think there's anything less than about him right now.
Yeah, Oko just trying to set up some of his shots. On the low, trying to set him up with the left. A brilliant outing so far. We'll see if either man will take the bait in this third and final stanza. Only 3 minutes left. Somebody has to go home with the gold.
Allure's really got to try and up the ante in this round to take the win. Isaac Oko needs to remain composed.
Straight into it immediately. Great body of work there from Allure. Law studying sports science along with boxing here, living and breathing in the sports world. He's looking like he's breathing very well inside the ring at the minute as well.
He was the national youth champion in 2020, Adam Allure.
He's definitely looking to add to his accolades tonight.
Yeah, both boxers highly accomplished, very decorated.
Oh, and a nice shot, a nice counter left hand from Allure. Puts Oko down. Oko seems bemused and passes it off as just a little setback.
I think Oko believed he just slipped there, yeah. Lost his footing.
But Allure looking.
Allure
looking to repeat the trend and put his man down again for a second count. The crowd liked it, Allure liked it, and the pressure is picking up.
Oko needs to stay focused.
Yeah, he can't let that count get the better of him now. Neither man should. But these things have a way of affecting us.
But this is definitely dialed the confidence of Adam Allure up. He's really going for it. He's really looking for those big shots. But being caught by them on his way in.
Yeah, Oko dipping it. A couple of like strange angles there that were getting himself caught up in body locks.
Seems to be becoming a frustrating bout for Oko.
Yeah, 35 seconds left. We'll have to see who wants it more here in the final moments.
Coming scrappy as we get to the end of this final round. We're going into the last 20 seconds here. Nice head movement from Oko.
Just a looping left hand misses. Just misses.
Allure's just not able to land those next big shots that he needs to be able to win the contest, and we're going into the final seconds of the final round.
And that is that. That's all she wrote. And we will go to an official decision to find out who picks up the under 86 NAC under 86 kilogram title between Adam Allore and Isaac Oko here. Priya, I'm going to ask your expert opinion since you've been on a roll this evening.
I don't feel like an expert at the moment. That one was really tough to call. I think Oko edged it. He had the slightly cleaner work. I think Allure had some pockets of success. Not sure how much that count's going to work against Oko.
22, please show your appreciation for both boxers. Well done, lads. So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we are at the scorecards. We're your officials and ringside. Score a split decision, 4-1 in favour of the new under 86 kilo national amateur champion. And boxing out of the blue corner is Adam Allore. A round of applause for both boxers.
Big, big win for Adam Allore there. Living up to his nickname of the Big Future as he takes home another big accolade. Commiserations to Isaac Oko on a valiant effort there. But a fantastic, evenly matched fight throughout for you.
Absolutely. Adam Allore was very confident going into that bout. He said that he is about to win the 2023 title. He wasn't wrong. Commiserations to Isaac Oko. I think they both put on a fantastic display. Two very strong, very talented young men with bright futures for both of them.
And with that, we move into our final category of the evening. The under 92 kilograms as we sound the unit alarm loud and clear as Damar Thomas from Power Day Hooks meets Joshua Antonio of Kent Gloves. That's coming up in just a minute.
Gentlemen, this is bout number 23, which is the under 92 kilo national amateur final. Introducing your boxers, and firstly, boxing out of the red corner, we're in the red shorts, white vest, and hailing from Power Day Hooks, give it up for Damar Thomas! And across the ring, his opponent boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the blue shorts with white vest, and hailing from Kent Gloves, give it up for Joshua Antonio! Your referee in charge of the bell, Mr. Alvin Finch.
Mr. Finch calling the action here. Our referee is Damar Thomas and Joshua Antonio. Glove up for the under 92 kilograms NAC title here. Our 23rd of 24 bouts tonight. One more to go after this in the same category. But a very, very scrappy affair here. Right out the gate. Some kind of palm strikes on offer from Joshua Antonio.
Damar Thomas, no doubt, being watched by Blair Mounahzy. He says that Damar Thomas is one of his idols at just the tender age of 18 years old. He's up against Joshua Antonio, age 25, who turned 25 last week, actually.
Yeah, the Joshua nickname, Joshua 1-9, referencing a quote from the Bible saying, "Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you are." Obviously, takes that quite to heart. Was the orthodox 25-year-old. His day job was a PE technician in a special needs school as well. Accolades include national senior novice champion and two-time box cup champion.
Both boxers took up boxing because they were getting into trouble at a younger age. Damar Thomas is a silver world medalist at the youth championships. Thomas trying to establish his jab and his straight shots, but being bulldozed almost by Joshua Antonio.
Yeah, he's coming forward quite. Oh, some big shots, but he's coming forward quite with not much composure and just kind of wild strikes. That, and because he's got his arms out wide as he's throwing, he's easily being tangled up with Damar Thomas.
That's where Thomas's advantage lies. Joshua Antonio comes in quite wild and wide, as you said. Thomas can just let him walk into some straight shots and move off at an angle. He'll make this contest quite easy on himself.
Yeah, Damar definitely looks the more technical of the two. Straight shots usually beat looping shots.
Although he got caught with a cracking shot just there, did Thomas.
Don't really want to brawl a brawler either, does Damar Thomas. It'd be better to try and keep peppering him with them jabs, but he just can't seem to get the space.
No, Joshua Antonio is definitely trying to cut his range down and not let him settle. He's really spoiling Damar Thomas's work at the moment in that first round.
Yeah, heavy breathing from Joshua Antonio straight away as well. Those big flurries that he's darting towards Damar Thomas with have got to be expending a lot of energy. Could certainly be his downfall if he wants to get through the next two rounds. Fair play to the Power Day Hooks corner as well. They've been here all day. Had some on the card earlier on and still here this late in the evening. Into the show.
Damar Thomas two. Straight out of his corner.
I suppose he's trying to combat the flurries that he's getting. Very nice peppering jabs though. Liking what I am seeing from Damar Thomas when he's able to get things firing off.
I think he's just sustained a cut there.
Yeah.
Just above his left eye, I think.
Yeah, Thomas with a cut on the left
eye.
You
can feel it.
Yeah. Something for.
That's definitely come from a clash of heads.
Yeah, something for Antonio to try and target here. Some big shots, though.
Yeah, that cut definitely needs to be looked at.
We're getting the referee to have a look at that. I think he just made it clear it was a headbutt. The referee letting us know it was a headbutt, then a clash of heads.
That impairs his vision in any way. The doctor might call for the bout to be stopped.
And that's it. The fight's over. Unfortunately, due to a clash of heads, this fight cannot continue. A big, underwhelming end to this contest that was just starting to get firing off all cylinders in this second frame.
It's a deep cut, though, and the safety of the boxer has to be of paramount importance here. No doubt a disappointing end to something that has been built up to all year by both boxers.
Yeah, I was really liking what I was starting to see from Damar Thomas up until then, but we took it to our MC, Craig Denham, to get things official.
Ladies and gentlemen, bout number 23, please show your appreciation for both boxers. So, ladies and gentlemen, due to an accidental clash of heads, your referee had to stop the contest. However, the contest does go to the scorecards. So, after the round of boxing, your officials at ringside scoring a unanimous decision in favour of your new male under 92 kilo national amateur champion boxing out of the red corner is Damar Thomas. A round of applause, both boxers.
Despite the outcome and despite the cut, it's Damar Thomas who takes the gold home after a unanimous decision, given how far the fight, how far the bout had gone in the rounds.
He deserved that win. He deserved the win. I would have loved to have seen that bout go the distance. I'd have loved to have seen Damar Thomas really establish his jab and his straight shots as he was starting to do. But that's boxing. It happens. And he goes home the champion today.
And with that, we have one more contest. Just the final contest coming up next between Gideon Antwi and Arlo Stevens in 92 kilogram boxing. Don't go anywhere.
Gentlemen, this is a bout number 24. It's the over 92 kilo national amateur final. And introducing your boxers. Firstly, boxing out of the red corner, we're in the black shorts and red vest, and hailing from Hoddesdon, give it up for Gids, the boxer, Antwi. And across the ring, his opponent, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing all blue with white trim, hailing from York, give it up for Arlo Stevens. Your referee in charge at the bell, Mr. Jeff Canal.
Our final contest of the day, Gideon Antwi versus Arlo Stevens. And it's time to sound the unit alarm one more time as the big boys go to war for the 92 kilogram NAC championship.
Arlo Stevens comes into the ring on his 26th birthday today. This could end up being the biggest birthday party he's ever had. Gideon Antwi, 30 years old, been boxing for 12 years. Arlo Stevens been boxing for 5, and both men have made a strong start to the first round.
Yeah, Antwi, we used to get in trouble on the streets a lot, and some lad once brought out boxing gloves and handed them to him, and they both had a fight in the street, and the entire street stopped to watch. And although he let his mum know that he did win afterwards, she did send him to bed early that night. And then he decided to get invested in boxing properly, lost a lot of weight, and then later, sadly, his mum did pass away, so he does a lot of it now in her memory.
Sounds like she really instilled the discipline in him required for boxing. Mm-hmm. He's really showing that he's working hard here this evening.
Yeah, he says his biggest accomplishments remain outside of the ring and believes that becoming a man after everything life has thrown at him, that could have easily gone down the wrong path and failed in life, but instead he's utilised it to become successful. You can hear these shots just landing between these two absolute titans. Big overhand right there from Arlo Stevens. Slaps the chin of Gideon Antwi.
Gideon Antwi doing well to get in from behind his jab against the taller boxer. But Stevens just moving around the ring. It's very fluid for a 92 kilo plus lad.
Yeah, Stevens is a Celtic Box Cup champion. Says that winning the ANC, the NAC finals tonight would be a massive achievement for him as a full-time boxer now for 5 years. If only he actually met Anthony Joshua many years ago and felt he was rude, so he decided to box until he could knock him out. Some motivation.
Whatever it takes, Harry. Whatever it takes.
Serving him well so far. A little warning from the referee as the final 10 seconds of this first round come to a close. A much better round there between these two absolute behemoths than what we saw last time round.
Absolutely, decent round to start with. Both boxers showing their skill, both trying to establish their own style. And again, styles make fights. We'll see who can do that well and better in the next two rounds. Outside of boxing, Gideon Antwi is quite the musical man. Plays the drums, guitar, loves art and history.
Very cultured man. He's a 30-year-old. Big second round coming up here between Gids the boxer and Arlo Stevens. Stevens repping York Boxing Club. Big right hand straight away there.
Using his jab well there, Stevens, to line up the rear hand. Again, boxing on the back foot, you have to be supremely fit to be able to sustain that for three rounds.
Yeah, because you know these big boys do possess the power to turn the lights off with one punch at any time.
And that could have been it.
Let's go. One, two. Busy.
Antwi just looking for his opening there. Maybe waiting just a bit too long before he throws his shots.
Composed shots from Gids as well. Straight to the sternum and the head. Mixing up very, very well. Oh, nice left hook from Gids to Stevens there. Made him think about his shot selection. And he's taking some big shots here, Priya.
Gids is going in for the finish. But still remaining composed. He's not allowing himself to get messy, which is a really good quality to be able to have. He can see that he's kind of got getting the upper hand here, but he's remaining composed and he's picking his shots well, but just walked into a lead hook from Stevens.
Very well matched heavyweight tussle so far. I just feel like this one might not go the distance.
Gideon Antwi just switching back to his orthodox stance. He went southpaw for a little while.
Final minute of the second round. One more in the books if it is needed, if it's necessary. But with the power these two boys are slinging at each other, it may not be on the cards. Very nice counter shots there. Very nice timing from Arlo Stevens.
But he timed that really well, but he is getting caught himself. It's becoming difficult to score this. A bit of a shove there.
Yeah.
The referee doesn't see it as a knockdown. And again, straight 1-2. Fast approaching the final 10 seconds of the second round. It's been an interesting one, Harry.
Yeah, very, very interesting affair here between two big boys that can absolutely box the heads off. Fun second round there. Good that we're seeing, like, heavyweights these days might not always be the most technical given the power that they have, but these two have all that technique and more.
They really do, and they're boxing intelligently as well. They've shown good ringmanship. They're able to position themselves correctly in the ring. They're able to move their feet well. They're able to land some crisp, clean shots. Yeah. I think they both need to tighten their guards up a little bit more. They're both landing heavy shots, but it also means that neither of them are defending to them either, so be good to see their defences a little bit more as we go into this final round.
Yeah, big deep breaths in the corner of the birthday boy, Arlo Stevens. Gets his corner, just asking to move a little bit more. That's his third and final 3 minutes begins. 180 seconds to decide the under 92 kilograms NAC champion. Really like the boxing style of Gids as well here. Very crisp, very clean. Timing his shots very well.
Just came in with two decent straight shots there, Gids.
Yeah, and he's making Arlo Stevens miss as well. Boxing very, very smart here.
Just slipping off, coming in from behind his jab. Bit of a back fist there from Stevens.
Stevens getting a little bit fiery now with some of these shots.
Starting to swing a little bit with that rear hand, Stevens.
Discipline fading a little bit here. And Antwi looks the more composed of the two. Both just trying to find that perfect moment to throw the perfect punch.
He's going to have to go back to his combinations, Antwi. He's not going to be able to win this bout of single shots. He's got to get in behind that jab, move his feet in and land his combinations. Move his head as he comes out.
Nice inside shots again whenever he's coming towards him. Gid is happy to stand and throw with Arlo.
Arlo Stevens really needs to establish his straight shots here and keep Gids at bay. Letting him get too close to him.
But he's only got a minute to do so now, even less so.
He just slapped those two shots. The referee picked up on that straight away. Got some really experienced officials running the show today. Really shows.
Yeah, they're playing it exactly by the rule book. No leniency, very, very strict officiating. It's what we like to see.
Absolutely. Keeps the sport clean, keeps the quality there. And Stevens is just landing some of his own shots, doing well with it at the moment as we go into the last 10 seconds of the final round.
Very nice movement there, very nice angles to cut down Gideon. But Gideon responds as well. A very fun ending to that third and final round.
Great ending for Stevens there.
He really started to shine as that round came to a close, making sure he left nothing in the tank.
I'd have liked to see some of that movement and angular work a bit earlier on in the bout from Stevens.
Yeah, 100% agree on that one. Now for one final time tonight, your take.
Again, I'm not feeling like the expert on this one. I think that Stevens might have just edged it, especially in that final round. He got off with some really clean shots, but I think this one could go either way.
Ladies and gentlemen, bout number 24, please show your appreciation for both boxers. So, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. We all officials of ringside score a unanimous decision victory. All in favour of the new male over 92 kilo national amateur champion. And boxing out of the red corner, it's Kids the Boxer Antwi.
A well-fought contest by Gideon Antwi there to take home the gold in the under 92 kilograms category.
So, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our boxing.
I think Stevens was a bit surprised with that result. It wasn't quite the fairy tale birthday that he might have hoped for.
And that goes to bout number 11's Bert Lees, Cameron Vuong. So, we will get the award sent out to Cameron. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, I'd just like to say a massive thank you to all the officials who have volunteered for today's boxing, everyone behind the scenes from England Boxing and everyone in attendance today. You've been absolutely fantastic. Thank you. We will see you soon. Thank you and good night.
Yeah, just a few words for ourselves to round off here as well. Fantastic display by Gideon Antwi to round off there with the sharper, cleaner, crisper punches. Clearly scored in for the judges. And just a side note of what our MC announced there, of the Cameron Vuong bout earlier this evening, fight number 9 that we had on the card, winning the bout of the night, and he will have his award sent out to him. So a big shout out to him on a momentous victory and a special award following. So to wrap up a momentous night once again here in Newcastle at the Virtue Motors Arena, for Preya Deshena and for Harry Williams, hopefully we'll see you this time next year. Good night.
Good night.